right, here we are for our fourth game.
It's
Gladiators versus, I think what they call East Coast Selects. Their jersey has both a U.S. flag and a Canadian flag. That's a tough combination. This will be interesting. Gladiators are looking for the first goal of this tournament. I'm hoping it comes in this game. Looks like we got Megan, Zoe, Molly, Gia, and Emma out the store. We have our usual light lineup here. And we're off. I will say, after complaining the whole tournament about the video setup that I've had here, this is pretty unbelievable what I have right now. This is a perfect spot. No glass, other than some very short, small spots. I got, oh, nice job by Eleanor. I should have mentioned Eleanor's in goal. I got power. This is really as good as it gets. I'm gonna try to hand this mic off. I got a very happy looking 9-year-old ready to do it. Let's introduce yourself here before we get on the mic.
Hi, I'm Kevin. I'm gonna be speaking. Okay, so I'm gonna piss off. It's the Gladiators versus the Selects, and Gladiators win it back, and it's pinned up in the corner. The Selects get it, and there you have it, in deep. They pass it up to the point, back down low. Well, it's cut off by the Gladiators, but they get it back. And they chip it out. They're coming around with the puck. They pass it in. Coming in. Down low. Dangles. Pass it. Oh, well, it's Pochet. Oh, the Gladiators goalie. She comes in. She gets cut off by the Gladiators. Here comes the Selects again with the puck coming around, passes it to the D. He comes in. Oh, and what a glove save! And she covers it with a big scramble. And I know. So we got one of the this off. The Selects win it. She fires it across, and it's a big scrim. She comes in, passes it over. Chitzen! The scene. Eleanor. It's a Gladiator's goalie. This morning, she wasn't playing. And now she is. See how she plays. Gladiators coming. Oh, this is spicy. Back to the defense. Wally pokes and gets out. The Selects pass it up. They're coming in. 2-on-1. Passes it. Oh, it's intercepted by the defense team. Here she comes, around in the corner. Oh, and it's good point. And the Gladiators pick it off right before the Selects get to it. Here come the Selects, down low, behind the net. Oh, she turns, and the defense is fighting for it. Here they come, the Gladiators have it. Well, they can't. Can't seem to get it out. It pops out to the point. She shoots. Oh! And it hits the goal in front. It comes to the point. And they shoot it. The defense keeps it in. It's around the corner. Behind the net. in front, it just hits the side of the net. When they come at it, well, it gets picked off. To the point. Shoots. Oh, it's blocked. Around the net. Oh, it's in front. And the goalie covers it. That was pretty good.
Pretty good.
Okay, so it's offensive face-off for the Sharks. And Leo Schechter's taking the face-off. Oh, what a save! Boy pops out! But Gia gets it out. And chips it. Oh, it's a block by Gia. To the point, save! And Molly comes in to get it. It's around. Kyle lands on the puck and she falls and then starts to get it. Mia has it. Oh, it's a penalty on the Gladiators. And it's Molly going to the box.
Well, they gotta play tough, don't they? I mean, if they play, the less chance they're gonna be looking at them. This is the tightest game they've had so far, 3-0.
Well, the last game is pretty tight, but it ended up to be. Okay, so it's around the net. Gio's on the point. So he goes out. Pass to the point. Shot tipped in. We'll see. Selects come in. He's got me to the front. Oh, what a save. The Selects pass to the defense. Mia ices it down. Well, since it's a penalty, it's Melis. The Selects. Come in, pass it. Oh, and ships it down. Zoe's on the puck. And the Selects squeeze by. The Selects are coming in. Oh, it's intercepted by Tara. It's a save by Elmore. What a save, and a scramble in front. Okay, so Zoe Calamitis is playing center. 13:56 left. The Selects win it back to defense. The defenseman Deeks shoots. Oh, it's blocked. Back to the Selects defense. Shoots, tipped. Oh, what a save. Oh, another shot. Save. Another shot. Oh, it's over the net. And that's it to the penalty. Molly comes out of the box. Megan just gets a piece of it. Mia. Just got to pass, but it's not it. He was trying to get it out. Goes right into the skates and such. Ooh! Well, it's a big scramble. And the body is in select spot, goes in. Oh! And we got a save. Yeah. Fourth save by Eleanor. Oh, Slack's winning face off. She shoots it wide. Scramble in the corner. Slack's kick it to the corner. Oh, shot wide. Slack's at the puck. Chip it to the goal. Oh, it's intercepted by Molly. Slack's at the puck. He's always after it. The Sharks have a pump. They chip it out. It's the Tyrus wall. And Zoe's trying to get the puck. Well, the Sharks get it.
Come on, let's go. Come on,
he's going after the puck. Zoe wins it back. looks at it in front. Oh, they shoot it wide. Oh, to the point. Oh, she cuts through too. She's coming around it. Well, she uses the puck and Gia tries to chip it out. Well, it's blocked by the defense. The defenseman's coming in. Passes it over. Back to the defense. Oh, it's blocked. Zoe's coming up with the puck. She gets stripped. And number two's coming in. They shoot. Oh! Number three has it to 82. To the defense. Shoots. It's scrambling in front. And it gets used to the defense. Number 21 has it. Passes it over to 82. Slap shot. Oh, and it's a save. Wow. Passes in front. Blocked by 9. Number 3 passes it over to 82. He shoots. Oh! Oh, it's left right there. Sitting right there. That was close. Lady Slacks come in. Passes it. Oh! Oh, it up. Covers it. This is a good game. Mia wins it back to Gia. Get it! Oh, it's a wrap. Around. And she is fighting for it. Well, so let's get it. Shot and what a save. Bye, Eleanor. Yeah.
Eleanor's lighting up.
She's getting peppered. The Gladiators have to get on their zone. We've got to get some opportunities. The score. Tires to walk. Chips around. Lady Sucks had it. She deeks. Shot. Save. And what a save by the leg of Eleanor. That was a crazy save. That. She got 3 pucks and she saves all. Lady Sucks had it in the corner. Put it in front. Deeks. Oh! Oh, and what a close save! Got a catapult. Lady Sucks had it around the net. Passes it in front of the defense. Oh, it's blocked in the drive. Lady Sucks come. The shoot. Oh, she scores! Yeah, Mama hides the cookies. Ooh, upper. What a shot. Eleanor was down on the ground and roofed it. That hurt. Have it around. She got some speed. The defense is coming in. She deeks around 3 and 2 above the defense. It's in the corner. She is fighting for it. They pass it in to the defense. See the defense. There's the forward. guys. So, 5:52 left in the Okay. Now we're gonna hear from Alyssa. How you doing? I'm okay. She just broke her collarbone a couple days ago. Yes. That's not good. Okay. So let's have it. Left. The first period. Shucks from the back. Comes in deep. He passes it to the forward. He passes it back. What a hard one. Gladiators are playing. They're playing okay, I guess. I guess to the left of players, they obviously get tired quickly. And so but they're kind of hard to shoot, but that matters. So. It's hard for. How do you feel about missing this game?
I mean, it's hard, but you know, I learned from it too. What I have to do better, I have to do worse. But, you know, something like this happens, you know, you have to just deal with it. And whatever the case may be, it's always a problem in that game. So, I'm hanging around, you know. It's not that bad. The season's already over, it's almost over, so nothing that I'm missing. So that was a whistle, and now we're back to the game. Okay, so it's right now, and so let's.
Yeah, I think the girls are skating hard, but unfortunately this team is just a little too tough for us. We're playing with a short bench, and we got one girl injured, and it's a shame because the girls are playing good hockey, but just exhausted. A lot of hockey for the weekend, and hopefully they can turn it around.
And especially a long, long time to get here. Defense gets it. She dangles. Oh! some mustard on him, and she's getting peppy with him. And it's offside. So it was offsides, and Mia's taking the first one. Drop the puck, and the Selects win it. They win it back, D-to-D. They chip it in. Okay, I hear what a parent in the stands. John, let's see what he thinks about this.
Well, I think we could score some more goals. It would be nice, but the girls were all working very hard. You know, they're doing their best, so that's all that counts. Hopefully they'll.
So how do you feel about missing a player?
Well, it's definitely hurting us. We could use some more girls on the bench. Our girls are definitely tired after playing four games, and we could definitely use Alyssa. She's a very hard-working player.
How do you feel about the coaching on this team?
Well, I think the coaches are great. They do a very good job with the girls. The girls love them, and they really help motivate the girls to work hard.
Thank you. And that was John. Okay, now we're going to drop in the puck. Nice. Gladiators, Zoe Galanudis is going to be taking the faceoff along with Molly Sullivan and Megan Stake, along with Gia Santarello and Tara Seawall at D. Lady Selects picking up in the zone. Drop back. Ooh, but and Tara Seawall walking to the point. Back down into the corner by Lady Selects. Pass. Back up to the point. Back down. Back up to the point. Oh, but she just loses control. Picked up now. In the corner, Tara Seawall in the lane. We're fighting for it. For our Gladiators. Picked up by Lady Selects. They send it down into the corner. Now they're fighting for it in the corner. Selects send it in front. Trying to get it out from behind the net. But defenseman Giovanna Santarello cannot allow it. Shot by the Lady Selects. Oh, but it's blocked by Megan. Tara Seawall just gets this is by Tara Seawall. And it's out of the zone. We're now here with a fan from the stands. So tell me, how do you feel about coaching on this team?
Coaching is excellent, but unfortunately we're running such a short bench this weekend. Our girls just don't have anything left in the tank. But I think they're playing as best they can, and I'm very proud of them.
Now, I ask something. How would you feel if we had a full bench?
I think we'd definitely be competing a lot harder, but unfortunately these Canadian teams just play one step ahead of us. Unfortunately, we have these girls that we're playing with, and hopefully we can get one in the net.
So, what do you think about the performance by Eleanor Rogers in the first period?
Unbelievable. I mean, she's doing a great job and pretty much stood on her head the whole first half. And, you know, there's just too many shots on net. You can't stop them all.
What do you think the players have to do to work on in order to win this tournament?
Unfortunately, I think, you know, they're playing as aggressive as they can. But again, you know, with the short bench, they're just pretty much completely out of gas. But again, very proud of them.
Okay, that's it for Seawall. Back to the game. Lady Selects, bring it in. Drop past the point, slap shot. Ooh, and just wide of the net. Lady Selects down in the corner. Sends it around, but no one's there to pick it up. Molly Sullivan is there. Giovanna Santarello fighting for it.
Win that battle!
Can't get it free. Lady Selects are on her. Not hope, but from Zoe Galavino. And there's a whistle. I'm back with Alyssa Papa Sedera, the injured player. How do you feel to be injured?
It's not fun. But you know, it happens, so you have to deal with it.
Do you wish you were out there right now?
Yes.
If you were out there, do you think this would be a closer game?
I don't know. Depending on how long we're playing.
So tell us, how did you get hurt?
So I was on a breakaway and I got pushed and shoved into the boards and my shoulder was in so much pain I couldn't even move it and my collarbone got broken. So.
Okay. We'll be back with Alyssa Papasadero in a little bit. We're here with John. How do you feel about the game?
I think they're trying. They're really trying. They're giving it their all. They're a little gassed right now because they're short bench. But, you know, they're hanging in there. They're doing the best they can. Tough.
How do you feel about the game?
Goaltending's been great. I mean, she's gotten a barrage of shots, and She's kept us in it. Could be a lot worse than it is. So she's playing hard. Playing hard, both of them. All weekend, both of them playing hard.
How do you feel about the coaching on the Gladiators?
Great. I mean, they're trying their best. They're getting the girls in good spirits, even though it's short days. They're doing a good job.
Thank you. We're at the game now. Police Alexa are flying in. Drop back to the point, but it just missed it. Oh, no one's there though for the pass. Picked up, trying to chip it out, but it's just denied. Javon Santorello now playing for it in the corner. Gladiators really could use a whistle. Gladiators really need to ice the puck. Oh, it's all over. The longer the Selects stay in the zone, the less chance Gladiators will have of scoring. I can see this. As you can hear, the fans in the crowd are not liking this one. Shot. Oh, and saved by Rachel. Picked up a zone boundary. She's trying to get out of zone. She just needs control. Oh, and a big hit. Shot, and it's blocked. I'm here with Kevin Sewalt, the cameraman. Tell me, Kevin, how do you think this game's going? Not good, the Gladiators. Might want to zoom out a little. I mean, you're zooming at the butt's rep, at the rough butt. Anyways, how do you think the goaltending is? Okay, thank you. Now, seriously though, zoom out, because you're zooming in at the ladies' butts. And, okay. Out here with
Hi, Jill, Mia's mom. We're just watching the girls. They're trying hard and doing a lot of shifts.
So, how do you feel about the shortage on the bench?
I think the girls are trying really hard and just using it to get better.
How is the goaltending in this game to
it? Oh, the goaltending is amazing. It is outstanding. It is outstanding. And you know what? They can go back to the States and bring what they learned and be an even better team.
So, can you tell us what number your daughter is?
My daughter is Mia. She is number 13, and she plays center.
So, what team does your daughter play for?
She plays for the Lady Islanders with a lot of the other girls on the team. And that's it. She plays for the 14U Lady Islanders.
Is anyone on your
team? Yes. Well, almost all the girls were teammates last year, and this year a couple of them aged up. So, Mia, Gia, Zoe, Alyssa, who's not out on the ice, and Megan's in L3, and I think that's it. They'll be moving up to the 14U next year, and they'll be leaving their beloved teammates on the 12U, but hopefully they'll be joining next year.
Okay, thank you. How is this game going? Dan, how is this game going in your opinion?
Okay.
How's the goaltending in your opinion?
Excellent game, excellent game.
Thank you. I'm here with the cameraman. So tell me, how's this game going in your opinion?
Well, I got a lot of great goalie picks for our goalies. I have a lot of good pictures of our defense playing defensively. I haven't had a lot of shots yet on goal, any of those pictures. I think we haven't had a shot yet, but it's still still 11 minutes left. You know, can't win them all as a goal.
How's the goaltending in your opinion?
Goaltending's been impressive. I would guess between our two goalies, we got to be pushing over 30 saves by now, 30 more. And you know, you can't ask more than that for our goalies. Our goalies are getting shellacked here, and they're both playing tough.
Who's your
My daughter's number 5, Carolina, just came off. Carolina Sherry. She wears number 5 for Dennis Potvin. You know Dennis Potvin was? Who do you play for? Very good.
We're back with John. Let's see if his opinions have changed. So now, how do you think the game's going?
Well, it's still kind of going the same. We could use some goals, but the girls are still working really hard. Yeah, I feel bad. They're definitely tired. They worked hard all weekend, and they could use a break right about now, I'm sure.
Can you tell us which one of the players are yours?
Which one is mine? Molly, number 91.
Thank you. We're back with Eric. Okay, so can you tell us who your daughter is?
My daughter is number 55, Tara Seawalt. She's on defense, and I think she's playing very good.
How do you think the team is performing in Europe?
Again, I think the team is doing excellent, but you know, I don't know if we're ready for this level of hockey at these Canadian teams. But maybe our next go around will be a little better next year.
I love that. Is that
actually
coming
to
the
phone? How do you know? We are back on the set. Okay. Can you tell us what position you play?
I play wing.
What side?
Both sides.
How's the coach? Because you're a player. What's your point of view on it? What is your personal point of view on the picture of what team? Out.
How do you just tell them just keep running hard, not to give up? You know, just letting the girls have fun.
Lady Allen is trying to pick up by the lady selects. Down in the corner, back up to the ring. Sends it, fires the cross. Down in front. Ooh, and it's picked up by the defenseman on the lady selects. Sent down into the corner. Lady selects not getting any shots so far. Picked up by Zoe Allen. She's got it. Well, this was disappointing. We are back with John. Can you tell us exactly how you feel?
I feel sad right now.
Why is that?
I just feel sad.
Is that because we're getting free?
Yeah, I feel bad for the girls. But they're tough. They're good girls. I'm actually not sad. I'm actually pretty happy right now.
They're doing pretty good.
Pretty good. Toronto's a nice city.
Most kids are these. I've been playing hockey since what, two?
I think so. I think they're born in the womb with a stick. I think they're literally the kid has a stick in the womb of the mom. And then they come out with a stick and they're stick handling already.
Well, that's for
sure. We're here with Kevin Seawall, the cameraman. So.
AJ.
Okay, so all y'all who thinks Kevin's cameraman on the Zoom and zooming in on people's butts are awful, then write us a comment in the comment section below. Anyways, Mr. Seawall, how'd you get into cameraman?
I just like cameras and stuff, and it's fun.
So, can you tell us why the zoom on a camera looks like a motorcycle accelerating?
Well, it's just easy for to zoom in and stuff.
All right, that's Kevin Seawall. Maybe after the game we could try and get Coach Ashley for Gladiators' opinion on this game. If not, then we'll get Coach Pete Galanudis. Defensive coach Pete Gallagher. Okay. Face off in the Gladiator zone. One up to the point by Flex. Selects now with it. At the point, sends it down in front of the net. Oh, but they're not getting shot at all. They're just working up the puck. They're just moving the puck. And if more goals, I think they just want to move the puck. So we won't get any. Now number five, Caroline Shannons. I don't know if I pronounced that right. It's worth it. She wears number five because of Dennis Parkman. We got 4 minutes left in the game. So, Kevin, tell me, do you think this game can go into overtime?
Definitely not.
Good answer. All right, we're going to head down to the bench. So, when the game's over, we will interview Coach. One step. Oh, now with a breakaway. Sending it in. Tries to break through, but just can't muster enough speed. Lady Selects are playing good, I mean, most of them have been playing hockey since they were 2, and they're probably 12 right now. So, you know, our goals are probably going to be playing for like 6, so, you know. I don't know. I know Giovanni Santarello has been playing for 6 years, playing since she was 6 years old. Now.
We got 2 minutes left in the period.
We have been waiting for the interview with Coach Pete Valandres. That will be shortly.
Yeah, okay. So, do you think we have a shot? Okay. Now, can you tell us what happened before the game? When you were getting here?
I ran out into the ocean.
Okay. Can you tell us why? Or can you tell us what happened?
I'd rather talk about it.
Okay, well, I'm sure if she's saying she'd rather not talk about it. Ugly hospital. Did it look like you came out of a haunted? Did it look like you came out of a haunted? Oh, yeah. Were you laughing?
Yes.
Were you upset that you couldn't play hockey?
Yes.
Are you mad that you can't go to Matt Martin?
Yes.
On a scale from 1 to 10, how bad do you wish you could?
10 plus.
Okay. Do you think if the girl, if we had a full bench, we'd have a better shot.
Yes. I think we would have played. We would have gotten to a lot of these games could be fun. And we could have had a shot. So.
You think that because. Do you think most of the girls on this team aren't very talented?
Yes. Everybody is good in different ways, which makes us all unique and as a team, so.
As a member of this team, do players get along well?
Yes, we all love to laugh and hang out with each other, have our funny group chats.
Who do you hang out with the most?
Gio. Giovanna Santoro.
Okay.
Thank you very much.
And that's Matt Martin's biggest fan.
And this is Pop Segal.
So far, it was a tough one. It was a very tough game, but the girls hung in tight, and they skated hard. They cleaned their hearts out.
How did you feel to be coach of a team who made it all the way up to Canada?
Well, I couldn't be more proud. You know, we finished in the finals in States in Buffalo. That was an amazing experience. And now we came here to Toronto, and the girls played really hard. I'm very proud of every one of them.
Can you tell me how it felt on the bench? Eleanor was playing that well.
It was amazing. To see Eleanor, the heart that she showed and the saves that she was making were unbelievable.
So, how did Coach Ashley rate this game?
Coach Ashley felt the effort was there from the girls. You know, we never make excuses on this team, but we only had 8 skaters and 1 goalie, so the girls did get pretty tired. This has been their 4th game at 2 goalies. Thank you. But it's been their 4th game in 2 days, so the girls are a little tired, but they really played their hearts out.
How many of the players that you coach with?
That I coach with? Oh, of course. There's Gia, there's Mia, there's Alyssa, there's
the
Zoe,
playoffs,
there is Tara, there is Megan and Molly.
Thank you. Okay.
Here's Kevin.
So, like, when you started this game, do you think the outcome was gonna be? Do you think like this is bad, or do you think they would have, like, you know, like?
When you started this game, did you think the outcome would have been better?
I thought the goalie kept us in the game for a long time. We were 1-0 almost till the end of the first period. And then it felt like we let in a couple goals, and the girls started getting a little, you know, down on themselves. We tried to pick them up on the bench, but again, it felt like they started to really get tired and they didn't have their legs from under them anymore.
So, here's Kevin.
Would you do this again if you had another chance?
Really, of course I would. I love hockey. Anytime there's a hockey rink, I'm there.
When did you start coaching this team?
I started coaching this team last September.
September of
2016.
When did you start playing hockey?
Oh, geez. Well, I started playing hockey, I think, when I was 7 years old.
Do you like all the girls on this team?
Every girl is amazing on this team. They're all very supportive of one another. They're great teammates and great kids. I'm proud to coach every one of them.
Do you think girls get along very well?
Girls get along amazingly well. They're very supportive of each other. They're a solid team. All right, guys, I got to get the hot dog.
One more question. What did you think was going to happen once you got into this game?
Once we got into this game, we were trying to play a very defensive system, and it was working, and our goalie kept us in it for a long time. We were all the way to the end of the first period at 1-0, but then I think they got a couple of rebound goals, and the girls got a little upset with themselves, and it happens, and they started getting tired. But we're really proud of them.
Thank you.
Kevin, thank you.
Thank you so much.
Nice job, boys. Okay. Want to sign
so
up?
That,
hey, guys,
that,
right here, just sign up.
That was defensive coach Pete Balanudis. Thank you all for tuning in.
Look at the Gladiators
Selects.
I'm Angelo. And I'm Kevin Seawalks.
Till next time.
Yeah. Okay.